Your mission, should you choose to accept it, is to build a Google Gadget. The challenge? Making it original, useful, and customizable. I'm Dan Lee with the Google Gadgets team. I'm here to brief you on your mission. Google Gadgets can give you the time, weather, sports scores, or pull feeds from YouTube. They gather information from around the internet and display it for you in a convenient way. You can find many other gadgets in the iGoogle directory. Now let's look at how you build a gadget. We'll start with a simple version and get more complex as we go. This gadget fetches and displays multiple RSS and Atom feeds from all over the web. It uses multiple API features and is highly configurable. Let's select the basic parameters. Say you really liked R&B music. You might then customize this gadget to pull together the latest R&B music editions on YouTube, Amazon, and iTunes, as well as pull the latest entries from your favorite music blog. You could create a separate tab for each feed. You should start small by making a simple gadget XML that just has the basics. You can make the gadget more complex as you go. The code here determines the title and height of the gadget. Now you need to add tabs to the gadget. Add require feature equals tab to the gadget XML, which enables the use of the API tabs library. You will generate unique content for each tab in the callback function. Now you have the basic gadget shell with four tabs. The next step is to pull an RSS or Atom feed for each tab. You will define the default value for each URL feed that will be loaded, but you will add user prefs so that users can configure their own data when they use your gadget. From the data, you can display different types of information about the feed, such as its name, display name, description, feed entries, and summaries. Once you have completed this step, users will be able to change the input feed URLs. Next, within your gadget, you should perform the fetch. We have an API method called igfetchFeedAsJSON. This is used to perform a fetch to the feed and return a JSON response back to a callback function that you define. Within the callback, use a JSON object to read the feed. The second parameter is where you specify the callback function. The third parameter defines the number of entries you want to fetch. The fourth parameter is a simple true or false depending on whether you want to include summaries for each entry. This large code snippet shows the callback function that generates the HTML based on the JSON data that is returned. Let's see what the gadget looks like now. Now the gadget is able to execute the basic functions you've set for it to perform. How can you improve its appearance and performance? First, you'll be responsible for formatting the UI of the gadget. You can add CSS rules to stylize the output for the gadget, but keep in mind some key points about UI design. Gadgets should be as compact as possible. Real estate on iGoogle is limited. You can keep gadgets compact by using single border lines, decreasing margins, and applying formatting to the tabs, such as smaller font size. Take another look at the gadget to see what difference these CSS rules have made. Since the amount of information from your feeds will change often, you can combat the changing need for space this creates with the dynamic height feature. This feature will automatically resize your gadget so that it will best fit the amount of information coming from your feeds. It will prevent your gadget from taking up unnecessary space. You can also add the analytics feature, a single function call to IG Analytics. All you need is a Google Analytics account, which is completely free. Pass in your Google Analytics ID as the first parameter. For the second parameter, you identify a unique path specific to your gadget. This function will report a page view hit back to your account and lets you know how many hits are coming from your gadget. Now you can put the final touches on the gadget. The more customizable it is, the better. When deciding what to add, just keep in mind the features you would like to have if you were using this gadget. For instance, you might want the ability to change the titles, tab labels, and number of feed entries to display. Here are a few code snippets that show what's required to make the gadget title and tab titles customizable. The last customizable feature you can add is to allow the user to specify how many feed entries the gadget should accept. Before, the code had specified there would be 3 feed entries. You could also define a drop-down menu for the feeds. we replaced the hard-coded part of the number of entries with this user pref. So now you've built your gadget. The last step is to put your gadget in action. How do you get it in the gadget directory? Submit your gadget to iGoogle. In order to be able to submit this gadget, you need to add some metadata about your gadget. This information is what will be used to help make your gadget more searchable in iGoogle's directory. Remember, users will have thousands of gadgets to choose from in the gadget directory, so you must attract a user to your gadget when they are browsing. Some key ways to do so are to find a catchy title for your gadget. Make it short and descriptive. A user should be able to know exactly what your gadget does by the title. Design an attractive thumbnail and screenshot. Images are important as this may be the only thing that attracts the user to your gadget. Make the thumbnail stand out and encourage the user to click on it. Once it's listed on the iGoogle directory, get to work on promoting your gadget. On your own website, you can add the Add to Google button. There's also a Share Gadget feature on iGoogle, which lets you send it to your friends. If you have questions about the Gadgets API, there's a public discussion group that we encourage you to become involved in. Members on my team moderate this group and answer questions as they come up. There are more than 3,500 members in this group, and it's a great resource.
You have now been briefed on your mission. Good luck.
Submit your gadget soon. The clock is ticking.